the essence of tickness is finding that blood meal, but not just any blood meal will do. Being a tick means spending a lot of time looking for food, and then when an animal comes along, taking that blood meal, getting off the animal, and hiding somewhere so that they can develop. But unlike other ticks, the deer tick is an ambush predator. They have to sit there and wait for you. They have no eyes. They have no way of orienting other than they've got little sensory hairs on the tips of their legs and on their mouth parts. And these sensory receptors are out there looking for warm, moist air, which could be exhalations from a warm-blooded animal. You get Lyme disease from a tick bite, and 85% of all cases of Lyme disease, they appear in June and July. And that coincides with when the nymphal deer tick is around. They're very small, about the size of a poppy seed. You get a typical course of illness with fever, chills, muscle aches, fatigue. You usually have a rash, but most of these things are easily treatable. And if you don't let the tick feed for more than 24 to 48 hours, it's very likely you will have aborted infection if you pull the tick off promptly. And so yes, it's in your backyards. Yes, it's a tremendous burden, especially if you have children. But most of the time, if you're vigilant, if you spray your ankles and your feet and your legs, as well as all the other places that you spray for mosquitoes, then you will probably be protected from getting infected.